Our long-term goal is to build machines that are as intelligent as humans. That's what we want to build in the long term. And robotics for us is a path to get there. We believe that the core of human intelligence is being able to understand our physical world and being able to manipulate our physical world. So we do research on general intelligence. These intermediate products from our research, we put into our factory robots, and that make them smarter. And we keep turning the crank so that we do more research, which produces better, more intelligent robots, which we deploy in more varied situations. And the idea is to keep going like that. And the business model is to rent these robots out. We have now tens of robots deployed in the field and producing things as we speak. So we are looking at many different applications in warehouses and factories. And we focus on tasks that are more complex than just picking. It is not just picking from a bin or tote. It's more about picking and manipulating that object and placing them precisely or assembling them to make something. And the easier examples of that are packing into a box or packing into a packaging or doing micro assembly onto a printed circuit board. That will be a more complex example of that. And these are all applications that are at various stages of deployment. And even before the crisis, our customers were looking into robotics, not as a replacement of labor. More they were struggling to find enough people to work to expand their business. Of course, with the crisis, that demand has in some ways accelerated because it is hard to find workers and people are falling sick. And you can think of it also in analogy to agriculture. If you think about how agriculture has changed over decades and over centuries, actually, it has gone from more than 90% of the workforce being employed in agriculture to less than 5% being employed in agriculture. And that's because a lot of automation, industrialization of agriculture. And you can also see that is why our food supply, even through the crisis, we are not worried about food security as much. And it is also showing us that we don't have to fear automation and robots as taking away jobs, because what you're going to have is a much robust production line, and also expanded opportunities. That's the way it is going to happen. Of course, we have to take care of the disruption and how quickly it happens, and we have to take care of the people who might be affected, etc. But it usually happens that in the end state, we have increased opportunity and increased robustness.